So in the last class, I explained about mainly ionization of the weak acids and weak bases. We have discussed the ionization constant of weak acids, that is Ka, and for weak bases Kb, right? And we have derived the relationship between Ka and Kb. Ka and Kb is equal to Kw. Now in this class, we'll discuss about the di and polyprotic acids. Di and polyprotic acids. So diprotic acids, triprotic acid, tetraprotic acid, these are different types of acids. Here diprotic means the substance which has only two replaceable hydrogen atoms. Monoprotic means the acid which has only one replaceable hydrogen atom. Polyprotic means the substances as acids which have more than two replaceable hydrogen atom are said to be polyprotic. You see, diprotic acid has two replaceable H plus ions. Two replaceable H plus ions. So this I called as basicity. Basicity is equal to what is basicity? The number of replaceable hydrogen atom is said to be basicity. For diprotic acids, two hydrogen atoms are replaceable. So right there, two. If it is polyprotic acids, polyprotic acids. So this I'll write as first triprotic. Triprotic acid. So which has three replaceable H plus ions. So for this basicity is equal to 3. Okay. So this is said to be polyprotic. This is called as polyprotic acid. Polyprotic acid means which has more than two replaceable hydrogen atoms are there. They are said to be polyprotic acids. So examples, H2CO3 is a diprotic because it has two replaceable hydrogen atoms. This is the structure of H2CO3, OH, so this is called as carbonic acid. So this one dissolves in water. First it can release one H+, and it form HCO3-. So for this I'll write acid dissociation constant is Ka1. Only related to basicity. Acidity also there. Acidity we'll discuss for bases. For acids, basicity. For bases, acidity. Okay. Got it? Now, so here, this HCO3- convert into H plus plus CO3-2 for this Ka2. What is basicity? Number of replaceable H plus ions. So basicity is number of replaceable H plus ions. Number of replaceable H plus ions said to be basicity. Now you can see H2CO3, carbonic acid. Carbonic acid has how many replaceable hydrogen atom? How many replaceable hydrogen atom means you see the structure. In the structure, this H plus is replaceable. This is replaceable. The hydrogen H plus atom ions, which are adjacent to the electronegative oxygen atom, is said to be replaceable hydrogen atom. Understood? So these two are replaceable. Now, how many replaceable H plus ions are there in carbonic acid? You tell me, how many replaceable hydrogen atoms are there for carbonic acid? Two. Because here we have two H plus. So you understand the meaning. Replaceable H plus ions means the H plus ions or the hydrogen atom, which are present besides electronegative atom, which are present besides electronegative atom, like oxygen, chlorine, chlorine. So they are said to be replaceable H plus ions. Now I have written Ka1 as a dissociation constant for removal of one H plus. Ka2 as a dissociation constant for removal of second H plus. Now Ka1, Ka2. Can you tell me which is more? Out of Ka1, Ka2, which is more? Ka1 greater than Ka2 or Ka2 greater than Ka1? Okay. You see here, I'm telling that from neutral molecule we are removing one H plus. From neutral molecule we are removing H plus. Here I write the value also. Ka1 for this is equal to experimental value, all right? 4.3 into 10 power minus 7. Ka2 is 5.6 into 10 power minus 11. You see, if I observe the Ka1, Ka2, which is more? Which is more in this? Ka1 is more than Ka2. So I can write here, Ka1 is greater than Ka2. Why? Why the reason? What is the reason for this? You see, understand this point carefully. So this is neutral molecule. From neutral molecule, we are removing one H plus. Removal of H plus from neutral molecule will be very easy. Repeat once again. Removal of or liberation of one H plus from neutral molecule will be very easy. Whereas second reaction, second step, it is a negative ion. From negative ion, a liberation of H plus or removal of H plus from negative ion becomes difficult. Why it is difficult? It is negative charged species. From negative charged species, we are removing one positive charged ion. From negative ion, we are removing positive ion. Between them, they have attractive forces. Whenever they have attractive forces, liberation of second hydrogen becomes difficult comparing to liberation of first hydrogen from neutral molecule. That's why this becomes very easy. This process is very easy. That's why K value is more. This process is difficult. This process will be difficult because from negative ion, liberation of H plus will be difficult. That's why, as it is a difficult process, Ka value is less. So in the last class, I told you, as Ka value increases, acidic nature increases. As Ka value increases, acidic nature increases. So out of H2CO3 and HCO3 minus, which is strong acid? Which is strong acid? Which is more Ka value? H2CO3 has more Ka value. So I write it here. H2CO3 is stronger acid than HCO3 minus. I'll explain this. Once again, understand this. Is it completed? Did you write this? Completed. Okay. I'll tell you one more example. Okay. I'll tell you one more example. Understand. So I want the reason I'll write here. Removal of H plus from negative ion is difficult. Hence, Ka value, Ka2 value is less. So, acidic nature is also less. Okay. So we are removing the hydrogen atom from neutral molecule. From neutral molecule, we can remove the hydrogen atom easily. So we are able to remove the H plus ion from neutral molecule very easy. Whereas from removal of hydrogen atom from negative ion becomes difficult. So if it is removal of H plus from negative ion becomes difficult, K value decreases. When K value decreases, acidic nature also decreases. So another example you see. H2SO4. This is called as, I'll take carbonic oxalic acid. H2C2O4. This is said to be oxalic acid. I'm taking weak acid. I'm taking particularly weak acids. Because weak acids can develop equilibrium, no? So for this, oxalic acid structure you see. Oxalic acid, COOH, COOH. This is called as oxalic acid. Okay. So this we can remove the H plus. It can form HC2O4 minus. For this Ka1 value, these are standard values, 5.9 into 10 power minus 2. 10 power minus 2. Whereas removal of second proton, C2O4 minus 2. So for this Ka2 value is 6.4 into 10 power minus 5. I hope you are understanding. No need to remember the Ka value. We can't remember the Ka value. There are so many acids are there. For all those acids, we have so many Ka values. Ka1, Ka2, Ka3. You cannot remember. Even if you try to remember also, you can't remember. Okay. You see. So here, just I'm telling example. I'm showing you how it is greater than what is exact value, how it becomes less. I'm showing that. That's it. Okay, I'm just writing. In HCl, sulfuric acid is more strong acidic. Sulfuric acid is more strong acidic. But sulfuric acid is strong acid. Strong acid, we can't identify this type of equilibrium. We don't get equilibrium for strong acid. For weak acids, we'll get equilibrium. Okay, here also Ka1 is greater than Ka2. Did you understand why Ka1 greater than Ka2? I explain one second, listen. In this example, I written oxalic acid, we are removed on H2+. It is forming HC2O4-. For this, Ka1 value is 5.2 to 10 power minus 2. When Ka value is more, liberation of H2+ become very easy. Liberation of H2+ become easy. That we can understand from Ka value. As the Ka value is more for the first step, I'm telling that this reaction is very favorable. This reaction is very favorable and it is a strong acid. For this, Ka value is less. Based on the Ka2 value, I'm telling that the second process, removal of second H+ from negative ion become difficult. It is not very easy like this. It is very difficult. Why it is difficult? We are finding the reason. That reason is what? Removal of H+ from negative ion is difficult. Hence, K value is less. Why is it difficult? When you want to remove the H+ from C2O4-, H+, C2O4-, between them we have strong attractive forces. Due to that attractive forces, liberation of this H+ becomes difficult. When it is a difficult value, this is a weak acid. When it is a weak acid, K2 value decreases. Understood? Any doubt in this? Okay, fine. So oxalic acid, which type of protic acid? Monoprotica, diprotica, oxalic acid. Oxalic acid is a diprotic because it can liberate 2H+ ions. Now, so this is second example. Third one. H3PO4, H3PO3, H3PO2. Just tell me the basicity. basicity mean basicity means I told you number of replaceable H plus ions. How many H plus ions can be liberated by H3PO4? How many H plus ions liberated by H3PO4? I'll write the name for this phosphorus acid and this H3PO2 is hypophosphorus acid. Hypophosphorus acid. Yes. So what is the basicity for this? It is 3. It is 2. It is 1. This is triprotic. It is diprotic. It is monoprotic. How it is a triprotic? How it is a diprotic? You can see three hydrogens. In three formulas, you can see three hydrogens. But it is, I'm writing triprotic. It is a diprotic. It is a monoprotic. Why? You can understand this basicity from the structures. I'll draw the structures. Understand this. You see the structures. So I told you basicity. Basicity means what? Number of replaceable H plus ions. Replaceable H plus ions means that hydrogen atom should be adjacent to the more electronegative atoms. Besides more electronegative atom, how many hydrogens are here? 1, 2, 3. So it can form 3 H plus. So here 1, 2 only. It can give only 2 H plus. But here we have only one hydrogen. It can release only 1 H plus. Understood? So this is phosphoric acid, phosphorus acid, hypophosphorus acid. In hypophosphorus acid, in formula you can see 3 hydrogens. But 3 hydrogens are not adjacent to the more electronegative atom. Adjacent to the more electronegative atom, whenever they are present, they are dissociated into minus and plus. They are dissociated into oxygen minus hydrogen plus. This is liberated as H plus. But do you find that it can be liberated as H plus? Is it liberated as H plus? There is no more electronegative atom besides this. It can't come as H plus. It also cannot come as H plus. So these two are not replaceable by any metals. We can't replace this. This we can replace. So 1 H plus. It is a monoprotic. It is said to be monoprotic. And we can replace 2 hydrogen atoms. So it is a diprotic. And we can replace 3 hydrogen atoms here. That's why it is said to be triprotic here. Okay. So for this, what I can write? H3PO4 can liberate H plus plus H2PO4 minus 2. And H2PO4 minus 2, it can liberate H plus plus HPO4 minus 2. Whereas HPO4 minus 2 can liberate one more H plus, it can form PO4 minus 3. It is Ka1, it is Ka2, it is Ka3. So what is the order of this? What you can write? Ka1 greater than Ka2 greater than Ka3. Right? Yes, acidic nature. If you observe the acidic nature of this, acidic nature, if you observe, H3PO4 is strong acid. Next, H2PO4 minus, next HPO4 minus 2. And least is what? PO4 minus 3. Do you understand? So this is also called as orthophosphoric acid, orthophosphorus acid. Okay, this we can call as orthophosphoric acid or simple phosphoric acid. This is called as orthophosphorus acid or simply phosphorus acid. So phosphorus acid liberate how many H plus? How many H plus it can liberate? It can liberate only 2 hydrogen atoms. Ortho and name, they're just given as a name. Okay, there is no meaning like organic chemistry. Ortho, meta, para, that is different. Okay, so here H2PO3 minus convert into H plus plus HPO3 minus 2. Can it liberate one more H plus? Can HPO3 minus, can it liberate one more H plus? No, it can't liberate. So we have only two acid dissociation constant, Ka1, Ka2. Here I can write Ka1 greater than Ka2. Out of these two, out of H3PO3 minus, HPO3 minus 2, which do not have conjugate base? Which do not have conjugate base out of these two? Second one, right? HPO4 minus 2 do not have conjugate base. Conjugate base, Barbekondreno, they have to lose one H plus. It can't lose H plus. So there is no conjugate base for this. Okay? Understood this concept? Okay. Next concept, factors affecting acidic strength. Factors affecting acidic strength. You see, actually, when you want to say acidic nature, Ka value should be more. When more the Ka value, more the strong acid. Less the Ka value, weaker the acid. Now if you want to decide which is strong acid, that will be decided by the extent of dissociation alpha value. Extent of dissociation depends on two factors. So right here, the extent of dissociation of acids depends on one is strength of the HA bond. HA means acid. HA means what? Acid. Strength of HA bond, the bond energy required to break this bond. This inversely proportional to acidic strength. Inversely proportional to acidic strength. Second one, polarity of HA bond. Polarity of HA bond. Directly proportional to acidic strength. directly proportional to acidic state. So overall, okay, I'll tell you. I'll tell you end of this class. You see, questions I'll tell you. I'll tell you question numbers in NCERT. Okay. So I'll tell you, I'll send you on WhatsApp. Okay. Sajwal, question numbers I'll tell you so that you can solve that. You see, the extent of dissociation of acids depends on the two factors. One is strength of HA bond, second one is polarity of HA bond. At the strength of the HA bond, what is strength of HA bond? That will be decided by the bond energy. If bond energy is very strong, if energy required to break the bond is very strong, they can't liberate more H plus ions. So in that case, they become weak acids. That's why more the strength of the bond, more the strength of the bond, weak is the acidic. Less the strength of the bond, more the acidic. Okay, first to find, let us see, that is strength of the HA bond. Strength of the HA bond. So strength of the HA bond means what? Bond energy. This is also called as bond energy. If a bond having more energy, the amount of energy required to break that bond is more. That type of acids are said to be weak acids. If the bond energy is less, they are able to break the bond easily. In that case, they are more acidic. If you see that down the group, along the group, down the group, from top to bottom, bond energy, what happened to the bond energy down the group? Yes, I'll come to that hips here. Okay, I'll tell you now. So down the group, moving from top to bottom, bond energy, what happens? Decreases. Yes or no? When bond energy decreases, acidic strength becomes increases. So right here, down the group, the strength of HA bond, that is bond energy, decreases. Hence, acidic nature increases. Right? When bond energy decreases down the group, acidic nature increases. Why bond energy decreases? Example, HF, HCl, HBr, HI. Fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine. Atomic size, what happened? Increases. When atomic size increases, bond length increases. When bond length increases, energy required to break that bond decreases. So when the bond energy decreases, they can liberate H plus ions very much easily. So out of these four, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, down the group, bond energy decreases. When bond energy decreases, acidic strength increases. This is strong acid. Because it has less bond energy. Less bond energy. Whereas this is weak acid. It has more bond energy. More bond energy. Understood? Okay. So when the bond energy decreases, you can write as size increases. You can write that. As size, atomic size increases, bond energy decreases. From fluorine, bromine, iodine, atomic size, what happened? Increases. When atomic size increases, bond energy decreases. So acidic nature increases. Understood? So another example, example 2, so which is strong acid out of these 4? Which is strong acid out of these 4? Yes. Tellurium hydride. Tellurium hydride, selenium hydride, hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen selenide, hydrogen telluride, water. Here, atomic size of oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium. So atomic size, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium. Atomic size increases. When atomic size increases, bond energy decreases. So when bond energy decreases, acidic nature increases, right? So here acidic nature is increased. This is strong acid. This is weak acid. Do you understand? Yes, basicity also increases. Basicity also increases down the group, but not in halogen family, but not in oxygen family. In case of first A group, second A group. First A group, if I take the first A group of compounds, like lithium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, rubidium hydroxide, this has basic nature increases. In case of alkali metals, alkaline earth metals, down the group, basic nature increases. Correct. But I'm talking about the non-metals. Acidic nature, where we discuss? In non-metals only. These are non-metals. These are non-metals. But these are metallic hydroxide. Metallic hydroxide having basic nature. They do not have acidic nature. So we can't discuss acidic nature in this. We can't discuss basic nature in this. This is basic nature increase. This is acidic nature increase. Understood? Okay. Okay, fine. Are you able to understand? Next, second one. So this is about strength of the HA bond. Next, second one is polarity of HA bond. Polarity of HA bond. Okay. So I told you to understand this. Down the group, atomic size increases. Down the group, atomic size increases. When atomic size increases, bond length, what happens? Increases. See, this is HF, this is HCl, this is HBr, this is HI. That I'm explaining this. Okay. So here bond length is only small. Here bond length increases. Here bond length is further increased. Here bond length is very large. As bond length increases, why bond length increases? Atomic size increases. When atomic size increases, bond length increases. When bond length increases, atomic size increases, bond length increases. So bond energy, what happens? The amount of energy required to break the bond. Bond energy is very high for this. The amount of energy required to break this bond is very difficult. That's why this is weak acid. The amount of energy required to break this bond is very less, because bond energy is very less, because bond length is more. That's why bond energy decreases. I'm writing that's only. Atomic size increases. When atomic size increases, bond energy decreases. Why bond energy decreases? Due to increase in bond length. So atomic acidity increases. Understood? Okay, fine. Okay, next let us talk about the polarity of HA bond. Polarity. Polarity means what? The two atoms which can able to develop partial positive, partial negative. We'll take the acid. This is HA acid. This should develop partial positive, partial negative. if they are able to develop more electronegative, they are said to be more polar. If they are able to develop less electronegative, they are said to be less polar. When it can develop more electronegative? When there is a more electronegative atom is there. When there is a more electronegative atom is there, they can withdraw more electron and they can develop more electronegative charge. Yes or no? Whenever it is more electronegative atom is there, it can develop more electronegative charge is easily developed. When more electronegative charge is developed here, adjacent atom, obviously more electro positive also generated. So resulting polarity of the bond will be increased. When polarity of the bond increases, they can easily break. They can liberate more H plus ions. Acidic nature increases. So this is directly proportional to acidic nature, polarity. So how polarity increases? We can write this point. Along the period, as the electronegativity of atom increases, polarity HA bond increases and acidic nature increases. Okay, so along the period, when you from left to right, along the period, electronegativity of an atom in periodic classification chapter, you got this point. Electronegativity down the group decreases, along the period increases. When along the period electronegativity of the atom increases, polarity increases because it can withdraw more electrons. So from this bond, if this atom is more electronegative, it can withdraw more electrons. If it withdraw more electron, this bond becomes broken easily. So acidic nature increases. Right? So example, you see, if I take the carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, can you tell me which is strong acid? Which is strong acid out of these four? HF, yes or no? So along the period, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. So electronegativity order. So carbon to nitrogen, nitrogen to oxygen, oxygen to chlorine increases. When the electronegativity increases, polarity of the HA bond increases. So acidic nature increases. So this is strong acid. Okay. Another example. So this also you tell me which is strong acid. HCl, yes. So silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine are present in the same period. They are present in third period. These are present in second period. The second period elements, third period elements. No, we can't take it as zero. Okay. We can't cancel that polarity. Polarity, whenever it is opposite, we can cancel. Whenever charge is equal and opposite, then we can cancel. You see, this is a carbon dioxide. This is a carbon dioxide. If this oxygen withdrawing towards itself, so these two are attracting equally but opposite directions. When these are attracting equal and opposite direction, this overall net force becomes zero. Here we can take it as zero. But here they are not withdrawing electrons equally and appropriately. These two atoms are not withdrawing electrons equally and oppositely. Fluorine is withdrawing more compared to hydrogen. So in that case, bond will be broken. H plus, F minus are liberated. So they're acids. We can't take it as zero. Okay? So next, this is about strength of the acids. Understood? Next concept, hydrolysis of salt and their pH. Hydrolysis of salt. This is also called as another name, salt hydrolysis. Did you write this? Did you complete this part? Hydrolysis and hydration. Hydrolysis means the bond between two atoms. If I take AB, hydrolysis. Lysis means breakage. What is this? Lysis means breakage. Breaking of the bond by applying hydro. Hydro means water. Okay? So we are breaking the bond. Lysis means what? Breakage. Breaking the bond by applying water. If you break the bond by applying water, this can be converted into the H plus OH minus. Like this, we add the water. Whereas hydration means whenever we dissolve AB compound in water, if I take a container, in this we have water, in that I'm adding AB. When I add AB, it can be formed A plus, let us take here, I'll take HCl or lithium chloride. When I add lithium chloride in water, what happened? Lithium is electropositive, chlorine is electronegative. So this lithium plus surrounded by the water molecule. Because oxygen is negative. Lithium is positive. Between them, we have some attractive forces. And whereas chlorine also, we can see some electropositive hydrogen atoms. So between them, we have some attractive forces. So there is a, due to that attractive forces, they can liberate some energy. Energy is liberated. This is said to be hydration energy. So because of this attraction, this molecule, when LiCl will be converted into 2H2O. This is hydration. Okay? Hydration means molecule get absorbed on surface of lithium chloride. Inside the interstitial points. Whereas hydrolysis means we'll break the bond. Hydrolysis means what? We'll break the bond by applying water. Hydration means we don't break the bond. Water molecules get trapped inside the crystal structure. crystal structure, that is hydration. This is hydrolysis. Understood? Ardhaita? Understood? Yes or no? Okay, thank you. So you see, so here what we are doing is salt hydrolysis. Salt hydrolysis is just opposite of neutralization reaction. What is neutralization? One acid, one base combined, it can form salt plus water. Acid plus base gives rise to salt plus water. That is neutralization process. Opposite of neutralization is salt hydrolysis. Opposite of hydrolysis and hydration, the property of both covalent and ionic solids. Hydrolysis we can do for both. Yes, for both covalent and ionic solids. Okay, for both we can take covalent solids and ionic solids. You see, first I'll take one acid plus base gives rise to salt plus water. So this is said to be neutralization. This is called as neutralization. Whereas opposite of this, the opposite process of neutralization is called salt hydrolysis. Okay, so opposite process of neutralization called as salt hydrolysis means one salt, when we add the water, we are going to do hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means what? We are going to break the salt. It can form acid plus base. So this is called as salt hydrolysis. Salt hydrolysis. Okay. So it is a reversible process. Reversible process. When all are not reversible, we have one different type of salt. That is a different, that is irreversible. Okay, so irreversible process, and that depends on the type of salt also. Okay, so it establish equilibrium, that is hydrolysis establish equilibrium. Whenever equilibrium is established, so we write hydrolysis constant. Hydrolysis constant, that is KH. What is KH? Hydrolysis constant. We have written so many equilibrium constants. KA, KB, KW, KC, KP. Now it comes to KH. KH is hydrolysis constant. When we get hydrolysis constant in salt hydrolysis, when salt hydrolysis, salt undergo hydrolysis, it can form acid and base. When all salts will not undergo hydrolysis, that depends, we'll discuss it next further topic. So it can form acid plus base, that is said to be salt hydrolysis. And this salt hydrolysis is reversible process. If it is a reversible process, it establishes equilibrium. When equilibrium is established, we write an equilibrium constant. That equilibrium constant is hydrolysis constant. This is equilibrium constant. So here we will write this. So hydrolysis of salt is four types. Hydrolysis of salt is four types. four types. One is salt of strong acid with weak base. Strong acid, weak base. Next, second type is salt of weak acid with strong base. And third one is salt of weak acid with weak base. And last one is salt of strong acid with strong base. These are four different types. Both ionic solids will form hydrated, covalent solids will form hydrated. Ionic solids undergo hydrolysis, covalent compounds also undergo hydrolysis. Hydrolysis and hydration property is for both covalent and ionic. Both will undergo hydration, both will undergo hydrolysis. Okay, but that depends on the type of salt. I'm telling here, salt will undergo hydrolysis forming acid plus base. But all salts will not undergo. Salts will undergo hydrolysis, but not all type of salts. But not all type of salts. There are a few salts which do not undergo hydrolysis. Okay. So that which type of salts do not undergo hydrolysis, why they will not undergo hydrolysis, that we'll discuss in this concept. Okay. Okay, understood? So enough for today. I'll continue next class. Okay? Well, next class we'll discuss about these four types of salts. How they undergo hydrolysis, which type of substance will get, what is the nature of individual salt, what is their pH value, how to find out the pH, everything we'll discuss in next class. Understood today's class? All of you? Okay, okay. So thank you. Tomorrow we'll continue. Thank you so much. Hello, sir.